What's up, Dream City Youth? I'm Brooke, back with another Daily Devo. So, in the past few months, our world has literally flipped upside down from churches closing, schools closing, coronavirus, and events and plans being canceled. And it leaves us with the question, what do we do now? Do we just go with it? Do we just accept that this is our new normal? Do we take a quarantine break? No one exactly knows what to do during this time, but as Christians, here's some things we can do. First thing is being aware keeps you prepared. What are the viruses that we are close to? Maybe it's toxic friends, maybe it's social media. Maybe some of us, including myself, need to social distance from social media. Maybe it's idols or certain relationships, but the closer we get to those worldly activities, the more likely we are to catch the virus and be consumed by it. Ephesians 5:11 says, "Do not participate in the unfruitful deeds of darkness, but rather expose them." We have to be aware of what is weakening our relationship with the Lord and bring it to Him. When we bring those things that are keeping us distant from Him, it prepares us for the upcoming battles we might face. Next, we have to reinforce the source. Throughout what has been happening the past few weeks, everyone is sharing their opinion everywhere. And by reading stuff on social media or what your friend says or what the news says, it makes you question, what is your own opinion? But I realized our opinion shouldn't be formed by the news or what you read on social media, but ultimately by our main source, which is God and His Word. God's Word is truth, and at the end of the day, we can rely on it for the facts we need. It's like masks. If both of us are wearing a mask, we are more likely to be protected. So in our spiritual life, our Bible is what is protecting us from the worldly things. If one of us isn't using our Bible to dig deeper or learn more about Scripture and isn't using it as a source, we would be more susceptible to the worldly things. The next thing we can do is so simple. Don't be spiritually distant. We need to make sure we are not spiritually distancing ourselves from God. In all of this, God is the one we can go to when we don't know what to do, when we don't know what to say next, when we don't know how to respond, when we don't understand what is happening in front of us. He's the one we can go to. In Exodus 14:14, it says, "The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still." The great thing about our God is He sees what you're going through, and His heart breaks. He sees your situation and knows what you're going through, but He also has a plan and understands. And you know, sometimes it's hard to see the end of the tunnel, but He is still fighting for us. And in that verse, when it says be still, it doesn't mean be still and keep doing what you were doing in the past, but it means get closer to Him by being in His presence and by being aware of the things keeping us from Him and having our correct source, which is His Word, to learn from. So those are just a few things of what we can do when we ask ourselves, what do we do now? So thanks for letting me share. I love you guys so much, Dream City Youth. You guys are the best. Have an amazing day.